Good everyone, welcome to this video. Today we have a proposal for Battle Pass Season 6. Now, over the last few Battle Passes, specifically Season 4 and Season 5, let's be realistic here. Gaijin have made a bit of a meal of things, and they've kind of made it so that the Battle Pass vehicles, for at least half of them, are not worth the investment of time. And especially the free planes have been getting worse and worse. I mean, I thought the A6M6 was bad enough. I mean, it's decent ground forces. But then we got the Bowfighter, and my, shall we say, point about it getting worse was definitely proved, because I figured we'd have a Spitfire Mark 7, but apparently Gaijin don't listen to their peers. Well, at least to their player base. So what I decided to do was I would do some digging on the forum, well, the War Thunder forums, take a look at some vehicles that would be suitable for a battle pass, and just put them together. And obviously you'll notice there's four planes at the top. Well, one of them you might not even know is a plane because of the naming, but there's four planes that I'm going to propose, because obviously I would want them to have the vehicles that obviously I propose otherwise, but the plane can change, and obviously the top tier vehicle can change, but I haven't suggested any other top tier vehicles. Now, what I tried to do was I tried to make it so that the nations that have not been covered in the free planes part, so obviously Italy, Sweden, Germany, and China, have been covered, and that's what I plan to do. So that's why there's four planes up there. That being said, let's get into it. So we're starting off with the low-tier British tank proposal, and that is the Electo Mark II. This is a Electo Mark 1 with the 6-pounder. I figured this one would be a little bit more interesting, and its firepower would definitely make it more meme-worthy in top tier, because let's be real, that's what half of these people do nowadays. They take all these low-tier, fun-tier toys up to a high tier, a bit like the BT-7AF-32, and just go and smack. Like, that's really what they do. And I figured this thing being kind of like an ASU with the way it plays, obviously in the title of this in this forum post here, I decided this would be rather appropriate. So the Electo is lightly armored, it's quite mobile, but has a pretty dang decent gun. I would put it at around 2.3 to 2.7 for its BR. That way it has not only a decent lineup to back it up, but the 6-pounder can bring quite a bit to the table. And given its mobility, which is pretty decent, it should do fine. And plus, people will take this to the top tier, let's be real. Next up, we have the naval proposal. And I never thought you'd hear that coming out of our gob, because I don't really play naval, for those that are new to the channel. I'm more of a tanker and more of a pilot. I don't really play naval unless I absolutely have to. I just don't find the game mode fun. But I figured if I'm going to do something that is a boat proposal for a battle pass, I want something with a Bofors. I love the 40mm Bofors, one of my favourite guns, and well, this has two of them, so it gets my approval. This is the number 7 class torpedo boat, and it's for Japan. It is a bit on the large side for a torpedo boat, but you get four torps, you get two 40mm Bofors. I would put this thing around maybe 3.7, 3.3, purely because it doesn't have the greatest firepower. I mean, two 40mm Bofors, but that's literally all it has. It has no external guns other than that. And it has four torpedoes, but it's also on the large side for a torpedo boat. And I just figured this would be something pretty appropriate. And, well, no one really, like, looks for the naval stuff anyway, but I figured I'd throw this in because, well, yeah, it's got two Bofors, it's got four torps, it's quite, well, I mean, it's not very fast, but, I mean, it does get up to around 33 knots, so it should be okay, but don't expect to get anywhere on, shall we say, faster terms than most of the other vessels you'll meet, but it should be fine. Now we move on to the first of the plane proposals. And of course, this can change depending on what they choose for a top tier vehicle. And obviously, I'll show you my top tier vehicle proposal later. And there's actually a good reason why I chose the top tier vehicle that I did. But here we have the Maki C205N1. You may already know that we have the N2 model in the game, and well, this one is the N1. This doesn't really change much. The only thing that changes is the guns. This thing has one 20mm cannon in the engine hub and four 50 caliber Breda Safat machine guns. I don't know if it carries any bombs, highly unlikely, but even then, because on the forum post it doesn't say it carries bombs, so I'm going to assume it doesn't. But it would be something nice to have for Italy. And at the end of the day, since we've had Battle Pass vehicles which are not too, well, the planes at least, that were not too, shall we say, different from the regular tech tree counterparts, exceptions being the ITP and the F2G, I propose this. And, well, this is one of my proposals at least. Proposal number two is the Saab 18B late 1945. This is a vehicle which will no doubt get me some hate, and it's either this or a J-22 with cameras in it, is all I'm saying. Sweden doesn't exactly have a lot, and there was a J-21 with, I think, three 20mm cannons, but it never flew, and personally, I want to try and keep prototypes out of this. But essentially all this is the B-18B, which we're very familiar with in the game, without the bottom gun. The bottom gun was removed in the later models, and that's literally all the differences are between this and a B-18B that we're all familiar with in the game. It was either going to be this, that J-22, or the J-21 that never flew with the cannons, or a camera-equipped J-22B, I think it was, and the problem is they'll put that 4-0 and then it'll be useless. At least for this thing, I know it's a bomber, but it's a bloody good one. So there you go. That's pretty much all you need to know. Now for my German vehicle proposal, I was really struggling. And then I decided, why don't we just go over 109? Like, everyone loves a 109. And I saw this one on the forum and I thought, well, this will be perfect. And sure enough, it is. Essentially, this is the G8 model. It's essentially a G6 with either the 13s removed or the engine cowling mount, or the engine motor cannon, or cannone, or however the hell the Germans say it. I've probably butchered that. But essentially, you can choose which one you want to remove. Everyone with common sense would remove the MGs and not the cannon, but you never know. It was a armed reconnaissance plane, to put it simply. You could have stuff like 20mm gun pods fitted to it. You could also have a 500kg bomb, according to the forum as well. But let's be real, most people would probably just run the gun pods, or if they wanted to keep the performance high, just stick with the 1.151, which, to be honest, 200 rounds, it'll do the job just fine. And, well, you could put this thing at around rank 3 BR4.7 to match the regular G6. Because, remember, it's just a G6 with a little bit less weight in the nose, but a bit more in the tail. I figured this would be appropriate. Now we come to the final vehicle, which is China's proposal. And, my God, I was struggling. China has fuck all, is all I'm saying. And that's literally the only way I can describe it. So I selected this, the AIDC ACH-1 Chung Hezing, I don't know how you say it. This is an armed trainer slash attack aircraft. And yes, it's a turboprop for you Wyvern lovers. This thing is, well, I was really struggling, as I said. But then I looked at the armament and, of course, the speed. Two single 12.7 Brownings and gun pods, which, if you actually look, there they are. It has a bunch of bomb options, napalm, which is irrelevant, 12 rockets of HVAR standard, and 76, although apparently it should be 38, Mighty Mouse rockets. It's relatively fast. I mean, it's not as fast as a Wyvern, so I would put it around the same BR as a Wyvern. But, of course, it's got worse guns than a Wyvern. I would assume it doesn't turn as well as a Wyvern, because obviously it's only a low-power turboprop. You could maybe put it around 3.7 and it'd be perfectly fine, but that's just how I see it. And finally, we come up to the last vehicle proposal. We come up to the Fiat Iveco AVH 6636G. People call this thing the Centaur predecessor. I call this thing the tank from Just Cause 3. So there you go. It's not exactly the tank from Just Cause 3, but to me, it's close enough, and well, I figured this would be something pretty cool. Now, of course, it does have the very familiar 19mm gun to French players. I believe it's the F3 cannon. So, literally, all they have to do is take the gun from the EBR 1963, slap it on this, make a new model, job done. It's not particularly hard to make, and well, I was running out of ideas at this point, so yeah, I just couldn't think in that regard. But that's my proposal for the vehicles, at least. The challenges and all of the other stuff, like the additional like themes and things like that, I'll let Gaijin decide on that regard. I don't really have the greatest of ideas when it comes to thinking of themes. If it was me, I mean, we've already had, well, we had season one was, I'm trying to remember. Season one was really wacky. Season two was pretty weird. Season three was pretty alright. Season four was just dumb. Well, dumb in the fact that you got an A6M6 after all your hard work. And season five, which is currently ongoing, is a mixed bag because you get a bowfighter at the end of it, if you're a free-to-play player, that is. But that's just my short proposal and list of vehicles that I would put in. Obviously, the themes and everything, guys, you can do. I don't care about those. I just wanted to suggest some vehicles which would be suitable. And not only that, I can actually pick stuff that it actually has good taste and won't flop on day one, like the bowfighter and the A6M6 did. But anyway, I'm gonna let you guys off. I hope you enjoyed today's video on the Battle Pass Season 6 proposal. If you'd want to see more proposals in the future once we actually do get around to Season 6, I will make a Season 7 if you really want me to. But anyway, I'll see you all on the next one.